During my development years, the medicine council met at our home every month. The tobacco use was not like any other that you would see today. People lighting up a pipe just for pleasure. They lit up the pipe for a purpose, as a tool to medicine, to be directed by it. So this is how they used it, as a means of focus, a means of communicating, as a means of becoming aware of what they should utilize or what they should follow. All the people being very sick, diseased, and mentally they were imbalanced as well because of the diseases. So they, sure enough, they found seven men who were supposed to be truthful, that never lied, that could be trusted, that was very worthy. So they were told, you will journey toward the rising sun in search of medicine for your people. And so they traveled, and every time they would pass a real test of being truthful and of being strong, well, then the road would narrow, the journey would narrow, and it would tougher. The requirements would get tougher until they were on a very narrow, narrow trail, and it almost seemed like they were not going to make it. So that what they did is they trusted their feelings, so they went on in a narrow trail. The trail that you might be thinking about may be what you're thinking about right now. Say, can we get down there? Well, what happened? They passed the final test when they just thought it was just too near to pass. The requirements were so stringent that it was too near to pass. So they got there and they went through, and it opened into a beautiful valley. And when that happened, there was a big thunder that came. And right after the thunder, it was like an announcement that they were to listen and hear somebody's voice. And they heard this voice from up above say, you have just observed the most beautiful valley there is. Within this valley, all the plants, all the trees and flowers and roots and herbs grow to cure all the diseases your people have. But before you harvest those, you must first acknowledge the very first plant that grew up in this valley. And that plant was the tobacco. And then the tobacco is called the ancient one in our language, Agayula. Ancient tobacco was actually used as a consulting plant before you went looking for medicine to treat patients. You would go through the ancient one, the tobacco, first. And then in this sense, either through the smoke or just by putting a portion of it in your mouth, you'd be directed towards the kind of medicine that you would be looking for the patient. Our people have known for many, many years that certain things can cause you to form a habit which actually takes your life with it. So in modern times, tobacco has been used in such a way that the people have formed multitudes of habits from smoking commercial tobacco. It's like they sought pleasure with it, but then the body would crave it so much that they would light up another cigarette after one another. Commercial tobacco is not really sacred. And one should really honor the tradition of the old tobacco, the ancient one. That does not form a habit or an addiction. Thank you.